the Wayne County Community College District. Today is an occasion of celebration, and we ask you to honor our graduates with dignity. Would you please take this moment to silence all electronic devices? Please conduct yourselves in a quiet, orderly manner when speakers are at the podium so that we all may hear the wonderful messages being conveyed. We are delighted to have you with us again this year, the Plymouth Community Band, under the direction of Mr. Carl Kaptishu.
Thank you. Here. Will the audience please rise for the singing of the national anthem for my very own Audrey Morowski, a member of the 2017 graduating class. Please remain standing through the invocation.
And the assurance of good things yet to come. Amen.
To my far left, Pastor Jeffrey Judges, St. Paul United Church of Christ, Mr. Scott T. Holliday, Member Board of Trustees, Mr. Charles Baddock, Member Board of Trustees, Ms. Denise Rollins Glover, Secretary Board of Trustees, Judge Ulysses Boykin, 3rd Circuit Court, Wayne County, Michigan. Honored guest speaker, Mr. Randall Robinson. Dr. Curtis L. Ivory, Chancellor. To my right, Dr. Patrick McNally, District Interim Vice Chancellor, Curriculum and Distance Learning Programming. Ms. Kim DeCaro, District Executive Vice Chancellor and Chief Fiscal Officer. Ms. Marla J. Edwards Wheeler, Member of the Board of Trustees. Dr. Patrick M. Kelly, Member of the Board of Trustees. Ms. Flora A. Gabon, 2017 Class Representative. Ms. Charmaine Hines, District Intern, Vice Chancellor, Academic Accountability and Policy. Our back rows, Mr. Brian Singleton, Assistant to the Chancellor for Student Success. Our campus presidents, Mr. Anthony Armeniak, Downriver. Ms. Denise Shannon, Downtown. Ms. Mawani Diggs, Eastern. Dr. Leticia Uma.
Good morning, dreamers. It is my pleasure to bring greetings on behalf of the Board of Trustees of Wayne County Community College District. It is truly an honor to be here today to witness your graduation. As this ceremony ends, you will transition into the next stage of what we hope will be a positive and affirming future. Your journey here in Wayne County Community College District may not have been an easy one, but I can assure you that the time will prove having been worth it all. You may be going into the workplace or moving on to another institution of higher learning to complete your studies towards a four-year degree. We salute your accomplishments and your commitment. Most of you have juggled family and work responsibilities to reach this day, and we congratulate you. We want to say thank you to your support and safety network, your parents, your spouses, your children, your family, and your friends for both their understanding and their support. You could not have achieved your academic goals without them. We hope that today's ceremony will be remembered for a long time to come, and one that you will always cherish. Enjoy this moment. Continue to dream. Again, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, go forth, do good, and know that you have our best wishes. Thank you.
We'll give you greetings on behalf of the 2017 graduating class. Ms. Cabana.
College and University Partnership Transfer Program, which which is an internship program, and partnership between the Economic Community College District and Michigan Technological University. In fact, I just returned from a 7 weeks research project yesterday evening.
Mighty Wayne County Community College. have the distinct pleasure and honor to be able to introduce our speaker, who I first met in September of 1967 at the Harvard Law School in Cambridge, Massachusetts, when we were entering first-year students. Our speaker is a graduate of Virginia Union University in Richmond, Virginia, which was his hometown, and I had just graduated from Hampton University in Hampton, Virginia, about 87 miles away. We were part of the 25 black law students entering Harvard's class of 550 in 1967. Harvard, I had the opportunity to observe our speaker, who had excellent analytical skills and was a major contributor to dealing with the issues that the Black Law Students Association dealt with at the school. He was a very serious student. One of my most vivid recollections of our speaker at the law school was his dedication to causes in which he believed. In our senior year, he had organized the Southern African Relief Fund and was sitting at a table in the main hallway of the Harkins Commons, which was a student center for the law school and graduate students, soliciting donations. Following our graduation in June of 1970, while on a fellowship to Africa, he delivered $4,000 in person to the organization Africa Unity's Liberation Committee based in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania. This committee raised and distributed relief funds and support to Africans fighting against colonial powers like Portugal in the countries of what are now Mozambique, Angola, and Guinea-Bissau. Also, it sent relief support resistance efforts in South Africa, Namibia, and Rhodesia. For a few years out of law school, he worked as an attorney with the Boston Legal Assistance Project representing indigent clients. Also, he has had ties with Detroit. In 1976, he joined the staff of the late Charles C. Diggs, Jr., United States Congressman from Detroit. There, he reorganized and ran the Congressman's staff for 2 years. The organization Trans Africa was established in July 1977 as an African American foreign policy advocacy organization with our speaker as its executive director. In his leadership role, he led the Free South Africa movement to end apartheid in that country, organizing demonstrations, sit-ins, and protests. He was jailed numerous times for these activities held in the vicinity of the South African Embassy in Washington, D.C. As an extraordinary author, he has written nonfiction works, including Defending the Spirit, The Debt What America Owes to Blacks, The Reckoning What Blacks Owe to Each Other, Quitting America, Departure of a Black Man from His Native Land, and Unbroken Agony, Hate from Revolution to the Kidnapping of a President. He is also the author of the fiction novel, Makita. His detailed analysis in these books is well researched and presents incisive observations about social, economic, and political issues, focusing on the African diaspora. As a strong and prolific advocate of social justice, this man has done more than just talk and write about injustices on an international level through his own actions. He is no mere armchair.
Distinguished faculty, staff,
staff, graduates, families, guests, good morning. Today is a very special day. What makes it special is the fact that Wayne County Community College has arranged for us to come together to acknowledge and applaud the ambition, the dedication, and the determination of each and every one of the students who is graduating today. Some time ago, ladies and gentlemen, today's graduates had a dream. They decided what they wanted to study. They registered for the required courses. They showed up for classes, even in the dead of Detroit's winters. They completed assignments, studied for exams, passed exams. Personifying the words mission accomplished. Congratulations, class of 2017. Please join me in giving today's graduates a rousing and well-deserved round of applause. This
day belongs to you, graduates. This is the day for which you have long hoped, a day on which much of your future will be built. You have proven yourselves to be persons of determination and perseverance. And these are qualities which will be essential as you move forward to chart the rest of your life. Hold on to these qualities, because determination and perseverance are the fuel which make almost everything that is worthwhile possible. As you look beyond today, graduates, some of you have the security of already being employed, or perhaps self-employed, or have a firm job offer waiting. If that is the situation, you are fortunate indeed, and we celebrate your good fortune. Many of you will continue on to university. Many of you, however, like graduates all over the world, have no idea where you will be working or when that work will begin. That is the way the vast majority of graduates, and it is so important first to take comfort in that fact. The fact is, it is not just you. And then it is important to transform that comfort into the calm and steady determination and perseverance that you will need to keep applying for jobs, whether your first 10 or 20 or 30 applications are answered or not. Many very successful people in this country, including President Barack Obama, submitted many applications at a time in their lives without being granted even the courtesy of a single response. The many letters they wrote, which were never acknowledged, the many interviews they had, which led to nothing. But keep on trying and writing and applying until the offer of that they had hoped for became reality. The key is to calmly persevere, whether one is seeking employment, or one is self-employed, or an admission to a four-year university. Perseverance is the fuel that propels us to our destiny. In addition to this graduation, I encourage you throughout your life to understand the importance of gratitude. Graduation is a time for celebration, to be sure, but it is also a time for thanksgiving. Not only in terms of your being grateful to have reached this milestone, but also in terms of your pausing to remember all those who, in ways large and small, helped you to make it to this point. Parents, relatives, friends, loan officers who went the extra mile, special professors, thoughtful administrators, you have not already made both your day and theirs better by taking the time to personally thank all of those because of whom one way or another, today has become a glorious reality for you. After today, graduates, you will return to your communities better equipped than you were before. You will return as forces for good in your communities. In addition to the skills that you have acquired here, take with you an awareness that your words and your actions will carry weight. And so habits as basic as offering encouragement to others, dealing with neighbors, co-workers, and even strangers courteously, Today is a day of great accomplishment. But there will be challenges in the days ahead. But there always has been and always will be for all of us. Train yourself, however, not to be overwhelmed when these challenges come along. Whatever circumstances, whatever the circumstances, do not obsess over how unattainable your goals may seem. Instead, calmly and steadfastly focus on the very basic 1, 2, 3 steps that you should and must take to achieve your goals, and take them. Because of all areas of life, that is the only means by which everything is ever achieved. 50 years ago, graduates, Wayne County Community College was just a dream. Not much more than an idea. Very much as you have good dreams in your hearts today. Back then, the college had no campuses, no buildings, not even classrooms. In those early days, those were the dream of a Wayne County Community College in the hearts of the visionary founders who had to arrange with various public schools for temporary use of public school classrooms. The people who were determined to create this college, however, were neither broken nor deterred by what they lacked. Rather, they gained strength from the clarity of their dream, and one step at a time, they faithfully built this massive institution in which we now are so proud. So too must you remain focused on the dreams that reside within our hearts. So too must you persevere, no matter how enormous the challenges may be. So too must you calmly identify the steps that must be taken and taken. When in need of inspiration in the years ahead, remember the miraculous story of this your alma mater. When in need of assurance that the impossible can indeed be made possible, think about the story of the school. When life's uncertainty is clear and your dreams come true, remember the years that you spent here and the role that this institution has played in your development. Encourage other persons to come here. Once they have come, encourage them to stay. Class of 2017, you dreamed, you strove, you accomplished. Continue forward from this place and time. Then ignoring life's obstacles and embracing its possibilities, I assure you, it is the only way to get things done. Heartfelt congratulations once more to you, Wayne County Community College, class of 2018.
Any more than I knew that Pharaoh Khufu
black built the Great Pyramid. I never knew that much of Southwest America, including the states of Texas, Arizona, New Mexico, and California, had belonged at one time to Mexico. I never knew much, but we have to know, and it means how important it is to learn so much as we can, about each other's cultures. We have to read voraciously. We have to study, and we have to appreciate and respect other cultures. That is under trial now in our country. That trial is brought to us by the President of the United States. Thank you very much.